Looking good. What's up, everybody? Today's the 289th day making Songbringer, and today I'm gonna play the whole. I'm gonna play the game. Look at this. I even got my controller out. So, yeah, playthrough today. What's up, Boogie? Hey guys. Happy Saturday. How you doing today, Boogie? Let's get all set up. Boogie, I think you're the only one here right now. You get to choose the world code. What six letters are we doing today? Hold on, let me make sure I'm in 30 frames a second. Oh yeah, we're all good. What six-letter world seed shall we do today? Means we don't get to play with any of these awesome items. Kirby's, coffee, let's erase coffee. Regular permadeath. Regular. Regular? Permadeath? Did the chat mess up? What's up with the chat? Regular, I guess. Okay, world seeds, world seeds. We've done no beer. Done poopy. Xanadu is always a great one. It's all well here. What's up with this? It's okay. All right. Well, I guess we'll do Xanadu. Or what about quarks? Quarks it is. Chat right now, because the chat ain't chatting. Chat ain't chatty, what's up with the chat? Quarks! Alright, world seed is quarks. Yep, so today I'm just gonna play through, take some notes. Oh, I should get my phone out. So I can take notes. Okay, started in the right place. That's good. Finn is ready for taking the notes. Wrong button. I always press the upload button instead of the compose button in the iPhone notes. Alright. Here goes the playthrough. Doop, 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 doop. Grass, 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 grass. Oh! Demon's tooth. The birds. Test. Testing. 1, 2, 3. Test. Okay, so since this is not permadeath mode, we have all these things surrounding the first few areas. Ah! Oh, there you go. Sweet. Internet freaking out? Well, I started the world. I did the world seed quarks. So this is quarks. Oh, yeah, I need to, like, level those out. Write that down. So these guys have I'll turn on debug. You can see the red collision for those are not all lined up, so you can't walk smoothly across. So I wanted to walk smoothly over Roback tiles. Alright. Note number one. Your Twitch player lost controls. You can't adjust the volume at all. Is that like, sounds like they created a bug or something. Oh, I'm getting rich here. Already got 2 diamonds. What could I buy with 2 diamonds? Everything! Anything! This is interesting. You don't normally see this. A closed off path. Right there. Alright, let's do this. I really want to add some more animation to this. Like, I want to do a zoomed in, like you zoom in on the sword. Yeah, so the seed is quarks. Q-U-A-R-K-S. Nobody's chatting right now. I don't know where everybody is. So I just chose one of my own. It's the first time I've ever chose the world seed. Feels great, man. What power. Alright, sweet. We got a little info window this time. This is the first time I've ever played the game where we've got some, you know, simple information like here. There's what button you use to use the sword. Which is pretty essential, I would think. Yeah, quarks. Oh, that was backwards hit. That guy gets quick. Jim! I still wish he was twice as hard, but he's the very first enemy in the game, so... Maybe permadeath mode. It'll be a little harder. Okay, so I do want to take a note there. The warp-in effect could be cooler for that guy. And he should warp in. First mini boss warp in farther from player and more noticeable warp animation. You don't really see him warping. All right, continue. No, we, oh, what? What happened to the Evil Awakening? What happened to this? Animation just stopped. Well, first bug of the day, here we go. Might have to fight that guy again. I didn't play the music? Oh wait, no, it did play the music during the fight. Okay. Yeah, I know it's saying it has no frames, but I'm just wondering what that has to do with. What's up, Arcane? Hey guys. Okay, let's verify a few things. First of all, in the sheets, output, it should output to, is it backgrounds or scenes? Might be scenes. Oh yeah, it's scenes. Okay, so let me check the scene sprite sheet. That's scene 0. I'm doing a playthrough, but it just crashed. So I started playing the game and it crashed right after the first. There we go. Scene 1 definitely has all the frames it needs for that. Let's check out scene 1 plist. This should also have all of its frames. Yeah, Evil Awakening 0 through 27. That looks good. Okay, so what happened? It's right here in the profile load animation, profile with name. What's up, Tom? We'll be back with the playthrough here shortly. I just got to fix this one little bug. It couldn't find the Evil Awakening sprite sheet, but it's there. Just need to figure out what happened here. Profile, get Evil Awakening. Let's check the Evil Awakening profile. See if anything is obviously sprite sheets there. Zero, scene1.plist. Oh, that'd be a good thing to know if it actually did this. Here's where it's loading the profile. It should have loaded the sprite sheets just a second ago. I would love to know if it loaded that sprite sheet. I don't think it saves anything about, yeah, it doesn't. Okay, wait, hold on. We should have assets, textures, scene, star. Yeah, it's there in the textures. Okay. Well, either it didn't load the sprite sheet. Tree.getChild sprite sheets. That should be loading the v.getKey. Oh, there's the problem. Found it. Evil Awakening text has this as its value, not key. That's worth checking the other sprite sheets for. What's up, Azimus? Gonna be playing through here in a sec. Just got this almost fixed. Common. Evil Awakening. Those are the only two that load anything. Great. Should be fixed now. Let's try this all again. Starting with the... Yo, you know what? We can play with a different world seed, too. If you guys want to shout out a world seed to play, feel free to shout out right now. We can start over. That was world seed Quarks. So either I'm going to try Quarks. You know what? What? If you guys want to shout out a world seed, go right ahead. I'm just going to check and just make sure Brad Gilbert! Oh, weird. It's all dark all of a sudden. Oh, wait, maybe this is how it was. Oh, yeah, it's because I played this for a minute or two and it got dark. Yeah, three diamonds. Okay, I gotta fight this guy. Whoa, no sword? Wait. No sword. So I'm just gonna check if this guy works. So if anybody's in the chat and you feel like changing the world seed, go right ahead. I can start the game over. It's early enough. So what I would need from you is six letters. Six letter world seed. You're right, the HUD is gone. What happened to the HUD? Oh, great. At least that bug's fixed. Do thanks is the seed? Oh! Arcane! So close! Del Resort. Looks like we're gonna do that one. We're gonna do thanks. That's a cool seed. So the HUD was gone in there. That's a good point. Let me write that down before we start over. Look, it's nighttime now. Nighttime comes so fast. Okay. Going back down into first the sword room. And the HUD was gone. That should be a simple fix. Show the HUD, don't show the HUD. Okay, starting over with World Seed Thanks. Whoops. Damn it. This is my buddy's save game. Nighttime. They're both nighttime. Alex Pita! What's up, buddy? Ciao! Bella Zio. Regular permadeath. Regular permadeath. Let's do permadeath. We haven't done permadeath in a minute. It's gonna be harder. Thanks. Thank you. Permanent it is. Thank you, backers. Thank you, people that watch this stream. Thank you, everybody, for all your interest in this game. Gibson. Gibson's a great seat, too. Man, we gotta keep that one for later. I always go with the very first person to shout out a seed, so... Delra Zorxel. Got it. Thanks is the seed. Interesting, it's starting the game at nighttime. It shouldn't be starting at nighttime. It should start like midday. Or maybe randomly. Start game midday. Mid-morning. It was supposed to be mid-morning when it started, but it's apparently not mid-morning anymore. Either that or the time of the game is already... Oh, no, that's the problem. The time started at 59 minutes for some reason. Oh, maybe it didn't... I don't think it reset the time. It didn't reset time when erasing. And erase doors. Ooh, it's always a good thing to play your game. Oh, it's Del Razor! Del Razor. You just ordered your Gibson? Awesome. Okay, so this is the World Seed Permadeath, which means... Or is a not the World Seed Permadeath, but it's Permadeath mode, which means there's enemies right at the very first few screens, and I'm not trapped. I can go to anything. I can go explore the entire game. I can play the entire game without the sword. But in regular mode, you have to get the sword. So it's just like a little guidance for players or whatever. For noobs. Basically, it's for noobs. People that are brand new to this game have no clue. What was happening was it was so painful to watch people play the game and run around the whole overworld without getting the sword. It's like, oh, have you never played Zelda? But a lot of people haven't played Zelda. Especially the old school style Zelda like this. Alright, so, anyways, I'm in permadeath mode, which means if I die, I'm dead. I can't play this world seed anymore, or this whole save. You got addicted to playing with the Xbox One controller? So good? Nice. Yeah, cool. How do you like the Xbox One? The Xbox One controller is just like a little more streamlined than the 360, right? I'm playing with the 360 right now. And I actually love it too. Actually, I used to prefer my Super Nintendo style controllers. But they don't work with a lot of games. And secondly, they don't have the joystick style controls, which are really nice for playing this game. Playing Songbringer is really, really great with the whole 360 degree movement. You can like walk in circles and stuff. So that's nice. No! Don't attack Jib! So we have a HUD right now. It looks like the problem was when I went back downstairs that one time and didn't give me the HUD. God knows why. One more little bug to fix. Yay! So if anybody joined the stream, this game's called Songbringer. I'm playing through it today. There's an alpha update coming out later this week. This guy, why did this guy appear right here so fast? Oh, because I have totally wandered around this world a bit. Eat it. What's that? I'm gonna pretend I'm an idiot and go over here. I don't wanna get that hat. What's that? Okay, I'll take the hat. Yes! The top hat drone! You got both 360 and the one's lighter. Oh! And they have a nice texture. Oh. triggers are better. Great. And you plug in your headphones? Whoa, that's pretty cool. Alright, throw the top hat, picks up items, turns like a boomerang. Alright, let's do this. A huge backpack for batteries, right? Oh, sweet. Alright, I think I want to bind my top hat to the X button here. It's more comfortable. In fact, I think I'm gonna do that by default. So the default binding for top hat is X. Starting getting to be nighttime here. Oh, that's because it was starting dark. That's right. Because I forgot to reset. Oh, check it out. This is a reward item area. Found some diamonds. Yeah, we got 28 diamonds already. And the top hat. Feeling pretty accomplished right here. All right, since last playthrough, the controls have really improved a lot because you can now, it's a lot more purposeful when you throw your hat diagonally. You actually have to be pressing a diagonal direction in order to throw your top hat in a diagonal. If I start moving in a diagonal direction and then throw the top hat, he goes back to throwing it the normal way. Nighttime is really cool too. I really would have liked to experience it though, starting from daytime. So that's the default. It will eventually start from daytime. Ooh, dead end. What's up, WG? Welcome to the stream, man. Whoa. Nighttime's hard. You can't see all the enemies as well. Thanks, man. This game's called Songbringer. It's coming out this year. I've been working on it for a whole year now, and yeah, so it's coming out late. Oh, what? Check it out. Is this level one? I found level one without having to use the item, the compass. That's awesome. All right. Well, nighttime. See ya. I hope this is level one. Wow, I've never had such a smooth playthrough, which is awesome because, oh, and that's really great too, being able to see the doors are clearly locked. I know, right? It's usually level 6, right? It's always, right? I don't know why level 6 is such a popular level. I know, it's a total first, and I think it's because I worked on the world generator better this. And I love the new door sounds. Oh, and it's so cool being able to see that door is totally locked now. Watching it animate that way. Yeah, got you. Oh man, loving this. This is really cool. These new doors are just epic. Way clearer. What's up, Rocket Bunny? What's up, am I proud of my other games? Not as much, no. This game, I really, okay, so when I started this game, I had this thought in my mind. I was like, what would I do? What would I create in life if it were the very last thing I could create in my entire life? Because I really wanted to be proud. I wasn't, that's something I realized in my life before I created this game was I'm not proud, not really that proud of my other games like Quexlore, Hero Bash, everything else I've ever created. Even though it was, you know, they took years to create, and it didn't really turn out that I was proud of it, because I think a lot of it had to do with that I didn't create the art. You know, I didn't really create the whole game myself. It wasn't my design. That kind of thing. So this game is all my own design, all my own art, all my own music. So I'm really proud of it all. You followed way back the first 10 days? Nice. Thanks, Delra. Oh, Del Razor. Sorry. Yeah, totally. Dude, door anims are sweet. Oh, and now you got key cards that are colored always a certain color per level. So all the doors in this level are red. And all the key cards are red as well. And also the boss door is red. So everything is just really clear. I'm way low on health here. I need some health really bad. Okay, so right now I have one key. You can see that in my inventory. Are you thinking about your next game? No, I'm definitely not thinking about the next game yet. I've already planned out what will happen, you know, kind of the outline of what the next game would be, but I'm not thinking about it at this point. Don't you think you should be proud of something you created? Yeah, I mean, I guess I should, but I'm not, so... Yeah, there's a big difference. Oh, it didn't do the unlock animation there. Okay, so it's supposed to do a nice animation when it unlocks, and I think it might have been because it was a horizontal door. So let me write that down. Horizontal door didn't do unlock. Oh, wait, no, it did. It did because I'm in permadeath mode. Okay, so in permadeath mode, there's a big difference between that. In permadeath mode, it unlocks a door and then immediately opens it. In regular mode, it does a nice long opening animation for every door. Whoa, that was close. I almost died in permadeath mode. Come on, give me some life. Oh! I'm getting tons of diamonds, but no life. Shut out of the life. Yes, this is looking really good. Oh, I like it. This one has a nice blue texture to the bottom. It's pretty cool. Oh no, these guys are hard. I don't know if it's smart to fight these guys. Probably not. Oh, whoa! Oh. Permadeath mode! Can't continue! Oh, that was a good world seed! Damn. I had a bad feeling about that. Well, that was fun. That was actually really fun. This is probably the funnest I've ever seen this game. Man, this is great to see this. It's only the alpha version. Is the hit detection visual hitbox style? Seems like you don't have to line up with enemies to be on the same line to attack. Yeah, of course. I can show you what the actual hitbox is. It's not like, yeah, it's more visual. Yeah, it's more visual hitbox style, right? So it's supposed to be more intuitive. It's supposed to feel right. Let's do that world seed again, but let's do it on regular mode. It's good that I died. It's good to know that the game is a little bit difficult enough to die. We're gonna do world seed thanks again, because I don't really like that. Thanks! Yeah, totally. Yeah. So this, yeah, right, this game, you have to, It is technically the same horizontal plane, but a lot of the time I'll actually make their collision box a little bigger, so it's sort of a combination between the same plane and visual. I'll turn on the, actually, that's debug mode right there. I'll turn it on again when you see some enemies so we can, you know, kind of have a better idea of that. Oh yeah, diamonds! Woo! Oh, there's so many diamonds in this one. Alright, so yeah, this time it's regular mode though, so thanks is gonna be a tiny bit different. The big difference is that the beginning here is more gated and more safe, more sheltered. You like a loading screen? Sweet. The only thing that kind of sucks is that I already know a little bit of this world. I love being surprised. That's why I created this procedurally generated game, because I love surprises. I guess it would be nice to add a few more things to the game that create surprises, even in a world seed you already know. But not too much. Can't ruin it for speedrunners, but like, maybe just a little bit of surprise. Or maybe it's a surprising kind of element that has nothing to do with what a speedrunner would play anyways, you know? Speedrunners skip a lot. I think it was this way. Whoa! This guy's rich! 11, 12! I got as many diamonds as Rocket Bunny's got years. You're having issues with your game? What's up, man? What issue? Not for long. Right, when's your birthday again? Is it January? Oh wait, here, let me show you the debug. So that's that little purple box is, so yeah, I guess that's not very visual at all. It's more lined up. January 18th. That's your sister's birthday? No, that's so weird, because my sister's birthday, I'm serious about this. Her birthday is January 17th. So close. Wow. Here's the 6, right? Yeah, you just turned. Alright, which way was it? Was it up here? Here's the 28th. Here's the 22nd. Whoa, dang. We got a lot of Januarys here today. What's up, Januarys? These guys are tough. Oh yeah, it was this way, huh? You're not like a zombie turned? Why not? You don't want to be a zombie? Something against zombies, man? Oh, look at this. It was actually a secret area. Well, how many? Oh, that was a tenner. There's the 18th in April? Oh. Wait, this doesn't feel right. This is not it. No. Oh, see, this one I need bombs to get past. It's the menus. Oh, you just don't have any idea how to do them? So it's how to do them, not how you would do them? Is that what you're saying? I have a feeling yeah, this is not it. This is the tough one. Whoa. It got really dark all of a sudden. It's because we're at night. We're at night already. Nighttime comes fast. Maybe we'll make the day cycle a little longer. Now, I guess it just needs to start at daytime. You don't know how to create the menus. Okay. Well, my recommendation is do a Unity. See, you're using Unity, right? I would just do a tutorial. I guess it was this way. Hello, fence. Wait, this doesn't feel right. Ah, this is the dead end, that's why. How in the hell did I get to level 1 last time? So easily. This time it's not so easy. Okay, so it must not have been there. Aren't you worried the player may get lost in such a huge world before finding the first dungeon? Yeah, Arcane. Okay, so that, yes, of course I am. And one thing that's already been done is there's these things here. So you can, these little grow back tiles keep you from going too far without getting the sword. So you feel a lot less lost when you have the sword. But secondly, to find the first dungeon, there is a random encounter. I will eventually encounter a random boss, which gives me the compass. And the compass I can use here on the overworld to locate level 1. In fact, I think I'm going to make it so the compass can locate multiple different levels too, so you can find more compasses for the overworld. Let's see what we got here. So I couldn't go left there? I don't know. I don't know how this... There's no tutorials for Perlin noise. Ah, see, here's the boss right here. This is the guy that gives me the compass. This guy needs music. Music, music, music. I already have that on my list. The other guy needs music too. What will those black orbs do? You really want me to tell you? It's a secret. Alright, I've got the biodetector. Coding 2D Perlin Noisy Game Maker! Attaboy Boogie! Alright, so let's use this. Yeah, see, it's pointing right up there. And I still have no idea how I got there. So easily last time, but it's like. Did I miss something? I can't go left up here. No. Yeah, this is not. Well, I don't know, it's like the world changed or something. Rocket Bunny. I think if you like Game Maker, stick with it, man. All these people that keep telling you to change, don't worry about it. Just stick with Game Maker. There may come a day, you know, give it a year, and maybe in a year you'll be like, I kind of want to try Unity. But for now, man, stick with Game Maker. You're learning a lot. You're learning a lot, dude. The game's becoming self-aware. It learned how to make it harder. Best idea for the minimap? What idea? Yeah, the thorns are supposed to grow back up. That's kind of what they are. They're a tile that grows back. You hit it, you clear it, and it comes back. A lot like Metroid. In Metroid, there's a lot of those kind of tiles. So wait, what's this? Oh yeah, that's level 2 or something. Game Vivo, what's up? Bolt? Dark Souls combat system? You know, like dodging attacks? Yes, there's going to be a dodge and also a shield. These are technically their skills, but they'll actually be items that you find, kind of, where one of them is a shield, so you can actually, you do nothing, you simply just, you know, as long as you're not attacking, a lot like Zelda 1, as long as you're not attacking, your shield will come up for certain kinds of attacks. And then the other one is the dodge roll, where you actually can jump out of the way really quickly, and it's like a perpendicular jump, allows you to get past, you know, to just get out of the way of some kinds of attacks. So yeah, there'll be that. If that's what you meant, is that did you mean something else, Bot? Or Bolt, sorry? I haven't watched any games on Quick yet. I need to do that. I need to check out some YouTube videos at least. Okay, I do not remember coming this way, but hopefully this works to get there. You're applying for uni and they said you need strong math? You don't have that in a computer science field? Help? What you want, man? Maybe you need like, maybe you just need to go to Khan Academy or something and start studying the math that you're weakest in. Check it out, man. Khan Academy. There's an app for it, too. There's also Coding Academy and a lot of other great online tutorials and academies, and basically, it's what we had in the 80s and 90s growing up. When I was a kid, we had actual tutors. Today, we have the online tutors. The great tutorials that we have today. So, but you could have bosses have a delayed attack. A delayed attack. Like, oh, so like, they like faint. They're like fainting, like, oh, I'm about to attack you, and then they don't quite. Oh my god, we're still. This is the hardest level one to find ever. I'm really wondering what the hell happened in permadeath mode that made it easy to find level one, and then this. Actually, I gotta note this. This is a really curious case of the world thanks and why it's so hard in regular mode. World thanks. Easy to find level one in permadeath. Hard to find level one in regular mode. Okay. Because this is starting to get crazy. No Amazon in the Netherlands at all? Really? None? You can't even order from Amazon? Yeah, okay, Arcane, I see what you mean, Arcane. Yeah, it shouldn't be this difficult. Really, this is probably a problem with the overworld generator. Okay, here we got something. This might not be level one, but at least I can get to it. Which level is this? It's level 8. This world is so messed up. The first level I could get to is 8. Oh my god, this is gonna be hard. And it's dark too, it's a really dark level. Can I make anything from AI robot without a uni degree in CS? I don't know, man. Scottish Pizza, oh, thank you, man. Thanks for pre-ordering, it's so cool. The new alpha update's coming out next week, so you'll be able to play this very version. Scottish Pizza, cheers, man. Thank you all for your pre-orders and for backing the Kickstarter and everything, because without that, I wouldn't be able to develop this game. I was very broke. Very broke. developer trying to start this game. Well, let's say there's a really big kind of boss. Let's say an ogre. It takes 1 second for the attack to land, raises the club over his head, and then slams. But you can only attack the ogre when you dodge his attack and then attack him, or else you won't be able to beat him. Oh. Yes! Bolt, totally. There is going to be that. In fact, you discover these skills, the dodge skill and the shield skill and a couple other skills which are for attacking. You learn those inside these other types of dungeons. These are the more of like the dungeon crawling style dungeons. And there's going to be three other dungeons which are more like mazes, but they also have bosses, and they're just basically where you're forced to learn to get it a skill or an item and learn how to use it. So yes, the enemies, the bosses that are in those kind of worlds will be tailored. They'll be custom tailored for you to learn an item, which is very Zelda-esque. And of course, you know, Dark Souls-esque as well. Yeah, these enemies have a little more hit points. They don't do more damage yet, but that's only because I haven't created... They will. Eventually, these enemies will do way more damage. And they'll have way more health. So you'll basically, to fight enemies even in this dungeon, you'll probably need to get an upgraded sword or damage or something, or combine your sword with fire or something. Aralel? Sorry, it's hard to read. It's hard for me to read. Yes, there is mock pathfinding. There's a flood fill algorithm I use, which makes sure that all paths are reachable. And, oh, there. That's the unlock animation. How did I get a key? Oh, I got a key in that other room. So yeah, there's basically it's A-star, but it's the beginnings of A-star's flood fill. So it uses a breath first, or maybe depth first, I forget. It uses pathfinding to make sure that every path is findable. So that's why I'm really curious as to why I couldn't get to level 1 here. So I will definitely check that out. This is kind of interesting to explore a harder level. This is level 8, exploring with only 3 hearts, 3 teeth. Did I graduate uni in CS? No, I did not. I never graduated university and never will, probably. I believe that life experience is more important than university myself. So I cut college and went traveling around the world. I actually traveled the world for a whole year. It taught me way more, I feel, than I learned in college. Because I was already making games before I went to college. What's up, Jota19? Yeah, playthrough time! I'm in level 8 here. This is like a hard level, but I'm only on the very first. I have no items, basically. Stayed off, what's up? Scottish Pizza, yeah, I have to mail you a code first, so that's why your humble library says nothing found. Sorry about that. I have to manually reply to each one of those emails so I can get your name to put you in the credits and all that. So I probably should get that dialed in so when you order from Humble, it actually puts you, oh, you know what? Here's a great example of what, Bolt was saying. These bad guys... Yeah, these bats, their collision needs to be a little taller, so they look more visual. When you actually can hit them visually, they should be hit a little bit more. So, bats have taller collision. That's all it really needs. So, this is always good to play your game. Notice these little things like this. Oh man, I'm rich. So Scottish Pizza, yeah, I will mail you the code later, basically, later today, yeah. Also, you can be able to get different swords for different play types, like one attacks immediately but doesn't do as much damage as opposite the larger sword, which takes longer to swing but does a hell of a lot of damage. Yeah. That's a night. Oh, shit. Why did I just quit? Ah, damn it. Have I checked the Garma Sutra article on Legend of Zelda enemies? No. Can you send a link? Or, no, you know, never mind. Don't, no worries to send a link, because I'll just, unless you want to post it for other people, but, I will look for that later. I'll just, because I'm going to have to, I would have to really shut down this whole playthrough to go copy that link and stuff. Or no, wait, I could actually open it on my iPad. Oh, that sucked, did I? I accidentally stopped this game because now I have to fight all these guys again. Oh yeah, so these guys are a lot more intelligent. So enemy AI intelligence increases with levels. So like this is level 8. So that's why the AI for all these guys is super vigilant. Like these guys really attack fast, and they are more aware of than enemies in like level 1 would be. Wow, I've been playing for 50 minutes already? It's because I died in Permadeath mode. Oh, yeah! I got so much diamonds, 127. Ready to buy something. Oh, yeah, more. Oh, did I already unlock that door? Oh, yeah, I already unlocked that door. Okay. I'm gonna open up this article here in Safari. There we go. Thank you. Thanks, State Off. I know, hitting him through the pillars. Right. That was really cheesy of me. This could be an enemy. This could be a really important item here. Oh my god, these guys are super hard. Oh, that was lucky. Oh, what was that? Looked like the bolt went around me. I think I read the one from Garma Sutra on level design. Remember that from a while ago. Alright, now I got a key. Means I can open up a door. Oh, this is so sick! Having single-use keys has transformed this game. It's so awesome to be able to choose what door I want to open. I can do World Seed Cheese. It's totally six letters. Thanks for being so involved with the chat. You're awesome, man. Thank you. Yeah. You're welcome, man, of course. That's really, you know, that's my ulterior motive for all this, is to just make friends, really. That's what I'm here for. These guys are so hard and I'm almost dead. That's why I'm fighting them through the wall. Oh, that was a barely hit. Yes, attack Jim. Oh, you're so good, Top Hat. I love you, Top Hat. Friend, get! Friend! Wait, is this something I don't know about? What is this friend get thing? Is that a reference to some pop culture I don't know about? Oh, finally a heart! I'll tell you, it has given me so many diamonds. Oh, there, finally it's starting to give me some hearts. It's not letting me open that yet, because there must be another enemy in this dark-ass room. Where are you? Enemy? Is that him? Jeez. You see something? You see something, Jib? Where is he, Jib? Point him out, Jib! What? Seriously, there's no enemies here. Did I use a key already? Oh, I used my key? Wait a minute. I think I used the key here. And the door is somehow still locked. Okay, I need to write this one down. Using a key on a locked room? Wait, what room is this? This is area 548. World Thanks. 548. Really gotta fix this. This is really important here. Can't be locked in a room. Let's see if I go out of the room and come back. Star get for Mario games? Oh, right. Friend get. You're bad at pixel art? Why? Oh, man. I think I got gypped here. I think it used up my key. Oh, man. This might have just broken the whole dungeon, basically. It used the key, but it didn't. Didn't give it to me. Let's see what this is. This is the room I already got the key in from originally. Ah, oh, I got gypped. Big time. That sucks. It's a bug. It's definitely a bug. Actually, this might be more important enough to just fix right now. I know, damn it. What happened here? Wait, is that a door I have not tried? No, there's two more doors to the left. This one's probably locked. Ow! Sucks. Okay, I can hack myself another key. Yeah, I gotta confront this issue right now, so save the game. No, let's go save the game back at that other area. Where I'm pretty sure 548. Pretty sure it was. It used my key. Alright. So first thing I need to do is close and see if that how that affected the save. So, or the key counter didn't register when you picked it up. I think I remember looking in my menu and I saw the key there though. Oh well, we can find out right now here by looking at there. This level two. This there it is. There's the data for this save game. So yeah, it opened up one door only. It did not use the door. It did not open the door part. Okay. All right, man. Oh, well then, oh, okay, so I'll have to write you, Scottish Pizza, can you send me an email right now with that, about that? Send it to Nat at Wizard Foo. So that's my address here. Here, I'll write it out. Nat at wizardfoo.com. Let me post that in the chat for you. Cool. So so basically I know to send your code to that address instead of your dad's email. Unless you want it sent to your dad's email. Twitch Wizard Chat. There you go. Okay. Let's see what happened. So it okay, yeah, it did. It only did one of the doors. That was the other room, 438 to 448. What keys? Okay, so I got key 81. Yeah, it used my key. It totally used the key right there. So I can give the key back. Yeah, let's give the key back and see if the problem happens again. Zenso Turi, what was the first thing you did for this game project, or what got me inspired? I'll tell you, man, what got me inspired was playing old school games. My inspiration for this game was this. If I were to only create one... Whoops. Oh, this is the wrong level, or the wrong seed. If I were to create only one more creative project in my entire life, what would it be? And here, let's just set this to be the default world so we can just jump in really quick. And I decided, I was like, okay, I was thinking really long and hard about either creating an album, because I also make music, or creating a game. And for me, it was just basically a personal choice, like, at that point. But when I decided on the game, I was like, okay, if I were to only create one other thing in my life, I'd want to create a game because game can have an album as well. Like, I'll create a game and an album. Oh, there, it unlocked that time. Okay, that was crazy. It unlocked that time, I think, because I didn't do it at the... Let's see what we got for key. Whoops. There. Yeah, so I still got this key. Let's do this again. So my inspiration was basically old school games. I played Zelda 1 again, and I was like, if there's one game I would want to emulate more than any other game, it would be Zelda 1. I love the very first Zelda because it's so open. You're like, at the very beginning, you can go any direction, you don't even have to get the sword. It never railroads you into any kind of choices, which I hate about today's games. And a lot of today's Zeldas even are like, you're so railroaded. So forced into choosing linear paths. I love open paths, and so that's why I want to create a game like that. But my main inspiration was, I want to create a game that surprises me every time I play it. And that's why I've created a procedural with this. It worked! I don't get it. Oh man, what the hell happened here? You sometimes struggle with committing to a project for a long time, uh-huh? You have a lot of little prototypes? Right. Yeah, I feel you there. It's really easy to get into that kind of thing. So maybe that helps. I don't know. Except diagonals, right? Uh-huh. Well, maybe Zen Soteri, maybe that's just the phase you're in right now. Maybe you're in a phase of your growth about games and development in general where you really need to do a lot of prototypes so you get these things out. And in fact, sometimes that's a strategy people use for creating games. They'll go and create, like, this is the 110-1 principle. And somebody did a blog post, I forget, but the principle is this: you create 100 different ideas for your game, then you go pick your 10 favorite ones and create prototypes for all 10 of those games, and then you keep play them until you decide which one that you would prefer to develop, and then you go and develop that game. So maybe that's just you're on track for doing that. 83, I think your second key was consumed after you passed already open red door. Was it? Oh, 83. Really good thought there. Let's see if that's the truth. So let's make sure this world seed is set up for that. We got this key ready to use. Quantity of 2 indicates that the key is ready to use. Quantity of 1 indicates that you've already used it. Quantity of 0 is you've never gotten it. So let's go to another red door. And try that. I'm not going to play with my... I'm just gonna play with the keyboard here for a moment so I can kill enemies quick. Cool pizza! Monkey donkey, what you mean by the mini-map idea? What's special about it? Okay, here's the door. So, I have one key. Alright. I still have the key. There was another red door over this way, right? There. So use my key there. Shit, this is a bad bug. I wish I knew how to duplicate it. Well, this room is so dark, mysterious. Huh. Let's try one more time. Oh, Jonah, yeah, that's a hotkey. It's just a debug thing. So I can press the number 2. Let me get back to playing with the Xbox controller. Yeah, if I press the number 2, it does that. So let's see what happens. So that's a problem. It unlocked the door. Oh, is that it? Yeah, oh yeah, it definitely unlocked the door and opened it, even though the door is locked. I might just have to take a note and say, you know. Let's try one more time. I feel like... Yeah, there's definitely going to be a secret item that kills every enemy on the screen. Or at least does a lot of damage to each enemy. Right now it does like 3 teeth worth of damage. The other possibility is that there really was a bat somewhere and the bat got off of the screen somehow. Okay, I just said one more time, like 3 times, but one more time. All right. So this door should be totally locked. Wait a minute, did you use my key there? Oh no, I didn't use the key there. Okay. The Luke Skywalker force push? What's the flying spinning H? No, you mean the little butterflies? Or the bats? And a troll item that brings it back to life when you leave? Boogie's all about the troll items. Okay, this time I'm gonna kill every enemy. It worked fine. I'm pretty sure it had to do with your. I think you guys are right. 83. It probably had something to do with the where I was in the and how it used the key earlier or something. Basically, I need to make sure that it never uses up a key without. Door. And what else? I guess that's... Oh, and also cannot unlock doors in a locked room. Yeah, the Black H. Yeah, that's like a bat. It's a TIE fighter. What's up, Pete Wally? Alright, I'm just moving on. I don't know what caused that bug there, but I will look into it later. I'll look at the code and go, what could possibly cause a key to be used up without a door opening? So. Yeah, bombs! Level 8, finally got bombs. Means I can open up secret walls too. Is it possible to use up the key because during the opening animation you approach it again? Yeah, possibly. Stayed off. Exactly, it might have just been that. I might have approached it at just the right moment or something like that. Which way, left or right? I guess right? This is crazy in the dark fighting these guys. This level is really dark because it's 8. It's like one of the hardest levels. So the levels get darker as you get further in the game. I'm almost dead, but I have a feeling there's a secret item here. Oh, damn it. So close. There needs to be a health refill item as well. You know, like fairies in Zelda. Damn it. Ha ha ha! hard because it's level 8. Oh, it kept me at the same point, though. It's because I'm in debug mode. It allowed me to, start over at the same spot. That time the door didn't open. Oh, that's because I'm not using a key. I already used the key. There's one more. Oh. Yeah, monkey donkey, I can't confirm anything just yet, but I do have some plans in the works and stuff for getting it on consoles, so I'll be announcing that later. A few months from now. I'm going left this time. Wait. I'm telling you, these guys have got an item. I feel it. Feel it! Damn. That lightning is so tough. Yeah, there we go. Aw, these bastards. They're tough. They got like a defense, they got super offense. Jim's going crazy though, he loves him. Let me find him. Nothing! Oh. I totally thought there would be a sweet item here. Oh, there's a door though. No keys, I got bombs. Bombs, I gotta remember that I have bombs now. South beam animation bug? Was there what? South beam animation bug? Where was it? Here? Nice safe corridor. My favorite kind of room. Alright, we got an item in here. What's this? Lots of bats and stuff because the enemies are not complete yet in the game. The enemies and the bosses, there's a lot of work left to do there. There's a lot of work left to do with the dungeons too, to make more art styles for dungeons and stuff. So, once again, you guys that are seeing this game, this is alpha version. It's not even beta. The beta version's coming out as soon as possible, like in the next month or two. Three, maybe. And then, once I get the dungeons and enemies done, that'll be beta. Another key! Alright, good. Keys are helpful. Oh, when the flying eyeball shot south, the beam animation was west? Yeah, there's problems with it, with their animations. I'm gonna have to kind of focus on that enemy in particular for a minute. Alright, so there's a door here, or there's a door back down to the left. I don't know which door to take. I'm gonna take this door, I guess. Got no health? Yes, you will, man. Alpha's coming out next Wednesday. Update. Oh no! Whoa, that was so close. That is a dangerous corridor there. Oh wow, what is this? I don't know if this is the actual switch or another switch. I don't know. Oh! This is so hard trying to play level 8. With level 1 items. Did I lose everything? I kept everything. That's right, yeah. Songbringer MMO? The thing about starting over is you gotta refight stuff, but just like Zelda 1. And I shouldn't be starting over here at the same spot, it's only because I'm in debug mode. Alright, I'm interested in what's over this way. Ignore these fellows! Oh, damn it. I wanna know what this does to beat these guys. Staying well away from those guys, they're gonna get ya. Yeah! Nice, that was a good bomb. Okay, I don't know what that just did. I have no idea what this just did. I don't know what switch this is, or what switch this activated here to do that. Maybe there should be a more clear sound when the door is accepting a key. Let me think about that. Because to me it does have a clear sound, but maybe I'll think about why it's not clear. It has a distinct sound for when it's locking, or locked and unlocked. So, but maybe you're right. Maybe there's not enough distinction there. Just lost all my health fighting these guys again. And of course, they're not gonna have any items for health. Oh! Well, I got a little farther that time. Well, I guess it's a good sign that the game is harder at level 8 than it is at level 1. That's for sure. And I need an easier mode? Hazardous, it's only because I'm at level 8. And this world is messed up. So I got a note to fix this messed up world bug. It somehow made it super easy for me to find level 8 and incredibly difficult to find level 1. You want to fight Jib, not me. Fight my little robot companion, he's so friendly. Screw it. Okay, if I walk in the center. Oh, they still get you? Okay, that's a bug. Pulverizers should never be right by the door. Pulverizers never by door. Yeah, I know the hat. Yeah. What's up, Proton? Oh, two spiders? Oh, whoa. Oh my god. Oh! That room is like impossible with only three hearts. Wow. That makes me excited though. I go, what? I don't know if I have any more keys. I don't have really any options here but to beat that guy. Thanks, Proton. You've been waiting for the spiders? Okay, let me try one more time. Maybe there's some. Oh, I could use bombs, maybe. Oh, yeah, let's try the bombs. I'll try not to get hurt at all by any other enemies on the way. Oh, damn it. Oh! Oh! This is like impossible to not get hurt. Jockeying. Oh, you see that? Oh, damn it. Oh, you can get through those guys. Oh, works. Oh, that was the Blitzkrieg bum rush. All the spiders set two bombs. It totally works for future reference. Wow. Oh yeah, well, I'm so low on health. If I get hit with even one of those guys, I'm dead. Come on, Jib, find some health, buddy. There's some. Yes! Oh! Firebombs would be great for spiders. Yes. Oh, wow, that was a really great room to... Look, I didn't even need to... Oh, there's a door! There's a locked door here. Yeah, hopefully speedruns are gonna be really fun. I really want to custom design things for the speedrun, the permadeath mode. It's basically speedrun mode. When's the update plan? Next Wednesday. Yeah, so next Wednesday the alpha update's coming out. Alright, I'm stuck. I need a key. There's two doors I know of that I would need a key for. You know what? I did activate that switch over there. Maybe one of these keys is a switch-based door. Or maybe that other door over there in the other part of the dungeon is a switch-based door. This is quite the challenge. I should do this more often. Directly play level 8 or 9. Wait, I already got that. This is fun. I'm actually having a lot of fun playing today. Wait. Wasn't that open before? Because I gotta kill all these enemies. Do you think Kokos has helped you a lot in getting this game done quick? Yes, I do. For me personally, it has, because I'm so familiar with Kokos 2DX already. You know, I already know how to do everything with Kokos 2DX, so that's why it's just so quick for me to implement this game. Cheesy, hide mine walls. So really, I think for rapid game development, I think you need to be very, very familiar with your engine. So whatever engine you're using, make sure you know it in and out. And then start using concepts which are gonna make your overall game development faster. There's two things you can do for that. Data-driven and entity component systems. So use entity component systems. Find out what entity component systems are and start using them. That will make your game development so much more rapid. At first it will take a minute because you're gonna have to like figure out what the heck an entity component system is, how it works and all that. But once you're used to it, and once you have a game kind of prototype already running with the entity component system, the rest of your game's development will be so much faster. Especially if you're going with the full length game. If you just wanna create a quick loot 'em dare game, entity component systems are probably not going to be a good thing because they take a little bit of setup work, you know? Unless you already have an ECS, you know, set up for your game and you're ready to go into your loot 'em dare with the ECS. So yeah, ECS and then data-driven. Data-driven can make your game super fast because once you've got it, and that also takes more setup work. Make the pillars destructible. Yeah. Oh, Jonah, that's a cool idea. I like this. I'm gonna write that down. This is a sweet idea. destructible pillars. So you cannot hide behind them. I like that because you can make it so they take a few hits before they get destroyed. So like maybe you hit a pillar and it cracks a little, and then it cracks a little more, and it cracks a little more, and it cracks, and then eventually it does totally just get destroyed. So I think I'm stuck. I have no idea how to. There's no more keys. It looks like this dungeon is either I can't complete it, or I did something wrong. Actually, the This is worth checking out. Okay, I'm gonna save. So yeah, I guess that's it for today's playthrough. I'm just gonna, Oh, look, I got 255 diamonds, though. That's cool. Yeah, so I'm gonna do some debugging and programming work now, but that's it for the playthrough for today. So, thanks for watching, everybody. But yeah, I'm gonna continue streaming and just, check out the bugs. God mode. I could God mode it into a different room. That's a good point. Let's see what happened here, though. I want to see what that world. I'm gonna look at the debug info for this world and see why the hell level 8 was not completable. Like, well, how did I get stuck? What happened there that. There's level 9. Here's level 8. Here's the whole map for that level I was just playing. Alright, see you, Boogie. So there was the first key, which I got, I believe. Let's check out the data too. So this thing should. Oh, I only got two of the keys. Three of the keys. Those are the three keys, and I activated switch 8-1, which is the first switch. Now for the fun, right? It's crazy that I do consider this fun. Coding is very fun for me. Okay, so yeah, we got three keys, 1 through 3. And we didn't get the fourth key, but so we shouldn't be able to open three doors. So I never opened up door number 3. You know what? It might have used up my key again. Or maybe it opened up a different door. Oh. Wait, no, that's the door I got stuck on. So let's see. I got key 1. I opened up door number 1. I got key number 2. I ignored door number 3 and went back over here and opened up door number 2. So I basically skipped. I actually did the doors in order. There's door number 2. I grabbed key number 3 and used it on door number 4. Which basically stopped me from being able to open up any of these doors. So, and you know what? And then I grabbed switch number 5. Oh. Yeah, so here's why it wasn't completable. Because I haven't gone through the programming part of changing to have more key cards than switches. So this dungeon here needed to have, this was a switch, and it really should have been a key card. Yeah, I'm wondering what I should do about that. Really, there should be more keys, more key numbers. So basically, I would go into constants, and I would change the number of keys. Where the hell is number of keys? Yeah, so no, the switch, I'm still going to have switches. It's just that. It's just that there's going to be one. There's really supposed to be only one switch, main switch, which opens up the boss door. And then the rest should be keys, mostly. And then also there can be gates sometimes in the dungeon. So a gate would be something where you would need an item to cross that gate, like maybe a bombs would open up that or something. Or dumb turret, it could be a switch that would dynamically open up doors. Right, totally. That would solve this issue. But I'm not sure if I want to go down that road because I want to differentiate between switches and keys. And I want it to be so. I want it to be really special. So when you go in a room like that one I was in where I fought those enemies and opened up the switch, I want that to be a special experience that you only experience that like once per dungeon. You know, it's supposed to be a really just unique thing. So, But that is true. I could. That is a possibility for how to solve this. Oh, there it is. Knum key types. 4. So, yeah, each dungeon could have 8 possible keys, or 7 possible keys even, and then switches. Let me look at this a second here longer. Before I commit to any kind of any solution here, it's probably best to think about it. Right, because so we got this switch 5, and you're right. If it had been dynamic, it would have opened up this sixth door right here for me. Yeah, switches are really only for boss doors. So yeah. Hey, what's up, Loeb? How you doing, Loeb Music? Rocket Bunny, what do you do if you can't come up with any game ideas? Go play games. Relax. That's. So, ideas come from your experiences and your intuition and your ideas, and all that is a very yin thing. There's yin and yang and everything, right, Rocket Bunny? So it's your yin. You need to more relax more. You need to go have fun. You need to go do anything to get your mind off of game ideas. Try not to think about game ideas. Think about anything but game ideas. And what's ridiculous about that is you will eventually come up with a game idea. Hope that helps, man. I know it sounds super opposite world, but it is true. Oh, it costs you 68 with tax? Oh. Or you could just ask the chat or take LSD. I wouldn't recommend taking LSD because you're only 12 years old, Rocket Bunny. I would save that till you're at least 18 or 20, man. But yeah, like... that probably will give you some great ideas. Personally, it's given me a lot of great ideas, yeah, but resting will work just as well for you right now. Yeah, I'm thinking key. Yeah, each dungeon can have up to 8 keys. All right, let's do this this way. Yeah, play lots of Xbox, totally. Play games, watch movies, climb trees, do whatever. Play football, whatever makes you feel relaxed and having fun. You know, the key is to get in a fun state of mind. All right, we're gonna have a lot more key items here. You're gonna do a course to get like a degree in 3D modeling? Cool. Or the Switch? What? What's that about the Switch? I'm definitely open to ideas here. You know, so thanks for the ideas, guys. But I think having more keys is gonna be cool, anyways. Now the keys are single use. Oh my god. Really, I don't even need to really track these keys as much anymore. But I'm going to anyways. Every key is going to have a distinct number per dungeon. I hope I did that right. And then K number key types is going to be 8. And we can compile. Play chess. Yeah, playing chess. Right? That's a nice way to activate your brain, but yet you're relaxed too and you're having fun. Oh, the switch is to get into a fun state of mind. Jonah, I see what you're saying now. Very, very witty of you. 5555556666677777788888. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I'm just trying to I always look over code I just wrote, especially like that, because it's like it's so easy to make little mistakes like that, and then you wonder why for hours. So when it comes to like numbering things, it's good to check them twice at least. So we got 8 key types, all these new key types. We need to go add these into constants. So add constants for all these keys. Nice, Rocket Buddy. Is that one for your book? All right, we got 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, 5, 6, 7, 8. Cool. Right? I love it. Oh, man, you weren't here, Rocket Bunny, the other day. We had some funny, crazy-ass quote. I was like, man, where's Rocket Bunny when you need him? This is going for his book right here. Three, 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 three. Oops. 4, 4, 4, 4. It's probably boring to watch somebody type in all these just simple, boring numbers, but almost done with this. Right on, man. Right on, man. Yeah, I know. I definitely say that all the time, don't I? I'm very West Coast. I've lived here my whole life. Talk like I'm a dude. Pretty much am a dude. People are talking about coming with ideas. I found that just forcing yourself to create something works. Oh, yeah. That can work sometimes. It depends on your blockage or whatever is stopping you. I start without an idea in mind and just play about until something clicks and then I roll with it. Yeah, that's a very experimental way to be creative. I like that. That works a lot with music as well. That's why you're, yeah. By the way, if anybody hasn't heard Loeb's music, you should check it out. Loeb, you should definitely post a link to your music, man. It's great. Both of them, right? You have two SoundClouds. 5, 6, 5, 7, 5, 8. Screens for Vim macros, right? Let's just go edit Vim macros. This is the Vim macro editing stream. Raiku, hello, my good old buddy, old pal. How's the project? The project is great, man. I just played through the game, and actually, the game is funner than it's ever been. It's looking really good. Man, it is indexing slow. Probably game show eating up the CPU here. All right, we got two more of these dungeons to do. Oh yeah. No, I was keeping on streaming. I was just saying that was it for the playthrough. Yep, I'm definitely a surfer. I'm not even really a surfer, but like I'm definitely a dude. I do surf a little, but like I can't stand up. I can body surf. I can like catch a wave, but I just can't really stand up very well. It's one of my life goals, I guess, is to be a better surfer. It's because everybody I know surfs. You started a new project? You've been making something every single day for 30 days now. Sweet. Cool, man. It's a new music project each day, or new music piece of music or something. Yeah, check out his music. So good. Okay, now I just got to make sure I didn't mess that up. Let's go through all these again. We got 1, 5 through 8. 1, 5 through 8, 0. 2, 5 through 8. 2, 5 through 8, 1. 3, 5 through 8, 3. 4, 5 through 8, 4, 5 through 8. 5, 5, 6, 6, 7, 7, 8, 8, 9, 9. All right. Okay, next thing, the dungeon generator needs to place these keys and stuff. Wait a minute, wait. What about those strings? Do we need to add a string for these? Nope, I guess just key. Let's get rid of those as well. Item key 1-1 is the only thing we need a key for. And when we get the description, something that it's something to make sure I continue to work and improve all the time. Cool. Yeah, you do, right? It's a great for building your repertoire and getting better at any kind of art or programming. Heck, anything you do, really. If you're doing it every day, you're going to get better at it. Programming, art, music, sound effects, story writing, writing in general. I think there's something that filters an item. Oh, here it is. Filter item type. If it's a key. This is just going to be KLM key 1-1 now. Okay. Actually, the existing item probably would have worked there too. In your opinion, music people, which instrument do you think is the best to start with? A triangle. A computer and music theory book. Loeb, very interesting there. I like Loeb's answer. Shoot, man, personally, man, it's I don't know, I'll tell you how I started. I started with the guitar, and that really helped me to learn tuning. Like when you sit down and you can like understand like what's the when you can hear something that's off, like gonna take this out of tune. Do you hear that? Can you tell this is out of tune? It's got this horrible noise. And I'm gonna put it back in tune. It's almost there. There, so it's like basically in tune now. Almost. So that really helped me to learn tunings. And then like singing is really great too, because when you sing, you're using your own voice, and you can learn the breath, and you can learn how to make notes, and you learn. You start to, when you learn to sing, you get to, you really get to know what a note is. Like I kind of know what a C is now, and I kind of know what an F is, and a G, and things like that. Drums are also really great for learning to, learning rhythm, and also learning to use every limb of your body at the same time. Drums are sick. Drums take you into this world where you lose your body, you lose like your whole, you lose everything, and you get totally in the flow. All you have to be in the flow to play drums. It's 'cause you have to stop thinking and let your muscles and your memory and your body just do it. So there's a lot of benefits to pretty much every instrument out there. Yeah, making videos on the MIDIs on the piano roll is a great way to start too, because you get to know like melodies, you know? You started with the guitar but found drums faster. You're thinking bass? Cool. Yeah, bass for sure. Bass is awesome. Bass guitars are great. Yeah, Scottish Pizza saying learn tab. It's easier than actual music theory. But there's a lot of important things you need to learn about music theory, but you don't necessarily need to learn how to read music, I think is what Scottish Pizza is saying there. Learning to read music, whereas you're like at those lines on the staff. I don't even know how to read music. I hate that. I hate the lines on the staff thing. But yeah, understanding tabs is pretty easy. But then there's a lot of music theory that goes beyond whether you're looking at a tab or looking at a music sheet that is very, very important. Like you should know what the circle of fifths is. You should know what keys are. You should know how many notes there are in a key. You know, you should know all these things. You should know what a fifth is, a seventh is, like a minor third is, and you should know the spacing between notes. You should know the difference between a whole note and a half note and the circle of all music. The music is so circular. Time, everything, rhythm, harmonics, right? Use buckets. I agree. Buckets work for drumming, dude. Totally. Yeah, Loeb says you should learn how to hear music rather than understand it. Yes. Yes. Learning to hear music, feel music, even. Okay, getting back to this whole key types and all that. Oh, here, this is going to be an issue right there. This shift should now be three. Going to look through these other methods here to make sure this didn't mess up. Music lessons with Scottish Pizza. Should do it like our good old Bob Ross. Yeah, you're welcome, man. Good luck on that. And I would love to know how you're doing on it and stuff and how you find music and all that and what instrument you end up learning at first. And yeah, dude. I think I turned up in chat and derailed the conversation to music stuff. No, man, there's no such thing. You should learn how to understand music rather than just hear it. X Pixel. Yes. These are all great suggestions. Different sides of the coin, but still great suggestions. Okay, I think this is all good. We got an item key. This should be all right. Okay, let's go into the dungeon generator and make sure the dungeon generator is going to work with placing the right number of keys. We've got num keys, which gets passed in. Num keys should be clamped. This is something really, really basic here, but yeah. Num keys equals clampy num keys between 0 and k num key types minus 1. That should have been there the whole time. Now it is. Yeah, don't you? Music is part of game dev. Yes, it's definitely. I won't ban anyone. Bet on heads, but also bet on tails. It's still light out. Wow. Feel like it should be dark already. Okay, yeah, so this is where it's gonna. Final key level. This is the big switch. Just kind of scanning over this code to make sure this is going to work. Here, this is the placing keys. This is the most important part here. Right now it does is switch. It puts the key, the last key becomes a switch. Look at it this way. You can read a piece of literature and feel a range of emotions, but something really important is understanding the environment in which something was written to really get a sense of what the author felt and why they wrote that, what they did. Interesting, XPixel. Interesting take on that. I like that. I never really thought about literature that way. Place key. So yeah, that should make the last key a switch. So we put like is switch. This room item becomes the last item. And the flags becomes a switch. Oh, get item type for key. This is really important here. You read Lord of the Rings like that? Whoa. Wow, that's probably a lot of time put into that. Okay, so this is going to make the switch type. The switch type here should be, yeah, this is going to be the very last switch number, which would be, now it's, instead of it being eight, the number, it used to be 8, now it's going to be 12 is the last switch. And that should work. Get item type for key, room pause on Z, num key types is 8, num switch types is 4, that's 12, so that gets passed into there. And this function should still be fine because it's going to be nums greater than num key types becomes a switch, otherwise a key. So yeah, that should still work. And this is just get item type for key number. Key numbers are clamped between 0 and 8, so. The checkers game. You liked it? Oh, man. I created that whole game in a week. I mean, it's all it is checkers with monsters. I agree with XPixel. Also, once you know how to, a lot of it is made, it becomes hard to shut the critical side of listening off. Just hearing the music is a nice change rather than automatically analyzing it. True. Yeah. That's a total phase that I went through too. Like I had a phase where I didn't understand how music was made. And then I had a phase where I totally understood how music was made and I overanalyzed it all the time and was critical of it and like liked music in general a little bit less. And now I'm into the phase where I still understand it, but I can totally appreciate it and get lost in it again. So there's hope. There's hope even if you do totally understand everything. It would be better if it was chess, totally. Malazan? Book of the Fallen? No. Is it good? You want to learn music so you can learn why you like certain songs? Oh. Yeah. Ten volumes, cool. Right on, I gotta check this out. Is it good? I'll just save a link here. Book of the Fallen. Gotta remember to get this. I need a great book to read. I haven't read a good book in a while. I mostly just like watch cartoons. Okay, I'm pretty confident this is gonna work. Let's just run it, see what happens. Hopefully it fixed all the worries in the world. Nice. Cartoons, greater than books. For animating, I mean, it's really helped me to become a better animator and understand animation in general. I think the world's still the same. That would be great. Oh. There's one thing I do need to make sure. When it draws the debug output for switches, it needs something else now because it uses up 1 through 8. 15 books, right? Cool. The last like 10 book series I tried to read was Robert Jordan's series. 8-bit cartoon would be cool. Dude, you haven't seen Code Monkeys? Code Monkeys is an 8-bit cartoon that rocks. You should definitely check out Code Monkeys. This is all about game developers. It's so great and it's so funny. I can't believe it only got like 2 seasons. I wish there were like 20 seasons of this. Code Monkeys, man. There's also 8-bit cinema. Oh, you guys, yeah, I beat you to it. I finally beat somebody to something. Songbringer the movie? Yeah, so switches are gonna need to be like... capital S, I guess. No, not capital S, like... I'm thinking the pound symbol, or maybe dollar sign. No, pound symbol. Let's just put the pound symbol where for switches. You wheel of time, that was it, yeah. Hey, so Scottish Pizza, it used to be on Netflix. It used to be on Netflix. It was streaming on Netflix, but now it's not anymore. I don't know how you can watch Code Monkeys anymore, but just have to look for it. It's gotta be somewhere. Okay, now the dungeons can have up to 8 different single-use keys. So let's look back at level 8 and how that changed it. It looks like we still have key number... Oh, why does it say I now? It should be... That's weird. Did I mess that up? Should be 1. Oh, constants is key? Is that the problem? Oh my god, this is so wrong. Okay, so I messed up this function. I gotta make this right. The name of the wind. The name of the wind. Same author? Oh, different author? Cool. What's the one I really loved recently? It's fantasy. Here's a book you guys could check out. It's really awesome. Queen of the... What was it? Queen of... Briar Queen? No, that's not Catherine Harbor. He was Briar King. Yeah, The Kingdoms of Thorn and Bone. This is a sweet series. I really love this series. This author, I really like him. Gregory Keyes, The Briar King. It's a cool one. Trilogy is where I draw the line for max series length, yeah. Screw Harry Potter. I like Harry Potter. I think it's great. I read all the books, watched all the movies. Is minimum viable product equal to pre-alpha? Yeah, I would say it's about there. Minimum viable product is sort of like pre-alpha, yeah. And then like prototypes even before that. One Punch Man, I've heard of that. Oh, Roiku, good point. Good point. What's One Punch Man again? Oh, is it anime? Yeah. Cool. I think I've got this on my list to watch somewhere. One Punch Man. Key world num levels times. K num key types. This is K num switch types. That was a huge bug right there. Just waiting to happen. Okay, there should be no more magic numbers here. Hell, this is something about magic right here too. Magic numbers, bad. Except for one. One is a good number to use. Okay, let's try that again. R.I.P. Wally, see ya. Briar King, yeah, Briar King's great. Night man, see ya. Oh, interesting. Interesting plot. Death Note? Anima? You thought three is the magic number? Cool, I'll definitely check out One Punch Man. I've been checking out a lot more animated series lately. I love Archer. Archer's like my favorite cartoon. And other things created by Adam Reed, of course, like Frisky Dingo. These other things, C Lab 2021 and all that. We got key number one, key number two. So this is now key number five should actually be pickupable. So let's do this. I'm gonna jump back in the world and see if this works. Right. So I would want to be at. Let's put the player back at. I guess the very beginning would be the most fair, but I kind of want to put the player here. Just screw that. So that would be one, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five. Five, five, eight. So player is going to be at 5, 5, 8. Pickupable, yes. 5, 5, 8. You're watching Code Monkeys? It's on Bing TV thingy? Cool. Dude, you're gonna love Code Monkeys. So I got that key. So I can get rid of those switch things. Let's turn those off. And continue with this dungeon. Let's see if we're gonna play this. Hey, I guess we are doing a playthrough now again. Hopefully this bug is fixed. Whoops. Use the bomb there. Oh, what's up with the bombs? I use up my bombs. That was fast. Yes. Oh yeah, you're gonna love that show, man. Second, how many bombs do I have? None. I have no bombs. I'm gonna cheat, give myself a couple bombs so I can get past that room. Cause I had bombs before. Now I'm giving myself two bombs. Four bombs. Let's live a little. Okay, so if I can get through this dungeon, if I can even use this key over here, then this bug is fixed. Well, I say that, but it might be take more than that to fix it. Wait, is this where I need to... Oh, right, so this is now a switch room. Oh! Lair, yes! Oh, I haven't seen Code Monkeys in forever. Yeah, we got a key that time! Should be key number 5. Yeah, their development room? Oh my god. Code Monkeys. I gotta rewatch that. I'm already low on health here. Damn. Maybe I can just blitz through this whole room. Oh, yes! Yes! Oh, wow, these guys are tough. Yeah! Oh, that was lucky as hell. Dude, I got so many diamonds. What's up, MC? Yay, the key worked! Watch out for these bastards. Oh, that guy, I didn't even see that guy in the corner. What's up, why not win? Yeah, I finished my playthrough a while ago and I found this bug with keys on levels that are really, really high up there. This is level 8 and I only have level 1 items, so it's kind of more difficult than it should be, but... So the bug I just fixed was with oh my god! Oh, what the hell? First of all, I should note this. What room is this? 618. Okay. Man, lots of bugs discovered. Thanks. 618. Unlocked. Then got knocked back in and doors. Won't open. So bug. Cool, man. Yes, the spider room, right? Yeah. Christmas break, right? Yeah. I know the pillar should break down too in the Thrasher City. Yeah. That's a good thought. The pillar breakdown is a great idea. What made me think of the name Wizard Fu? It's just like Kung Fu, but for wizards. I just wanted to combine the Eastern and the Western, sort of. Oh!
use the claw too.
Dude, I'm getting my ass kicked. I believe this door should be locked. Yeah. Dude, these guys are crazy annoying. They're just sitting in the corners. Yeah, I got another diamond. Oh, I'll take that health, thank you. Alright, here we go! Oh my god! Oh, damn it! Lock me in here again. Oh, alright, we gotta try this again. Are there any of those repair stations inside the dungeon? No, there aren't yet. And there really should be, at least... I'm cheating, I'm gonna kill all these enemies. There at least should be, items that refill your health more, right? Like, there should at least be, an item that refills... Like the fairies from Zelda 1, you know? MC Finest, what's up, man? Bye! Alright, we'll see you, man. You good? You taking off? Later, man. Oh, I really should have got the sword out before. Oh my god. This room is hard. I love it, though. Alright. I have to prepare my mind. Calm your mind. Closer that time. You can't watch the stream but get spoiled? Don't worry, man. It's not gonna spoil that much. There's no plot or anything I'm showing here. Ah, my own bomb knocked me back. I really want to beat this. This screen is crazy. Force being the hockey. Where's Valesin? I don't know. Nuke the whole room just for fun? Oh yeah, that's a good idea. Ooh, cactus? Hold on. This could work. If I eat the cactus in this room, be invincible for a minute. I'm out of bomb. Oh, it saves it. You need. Yeah, Jules. I don't know. I haven't seen Jules since. Oh, he was here this week. He was here a little bit ago. Yeah, better sword. Totally. The sword. You're gonna get some kind of increased damage on your sword, and that item would definitely help here. Cactus. Let's do the cactus. Invincibility! I got a good start in here. Do the nuke just to see what happens. I just realized that when you start over, it should give you the old amount of bombs you had. Continuing should replenish your old amount of bombs and cacti. That would be nice. Lightning sword would be sweet here. Fire sword would definitely kick ass. Yes. I'm doing the nuke for fun. That was fun. That was worth doing. Okay, I think I'm gonna try. Let's try one last time. Let's see if I can beat this room. If not, then I'm gonna cry. But yeah, but that's gonna be it for today's stream. It's been a nice long stream here and got a lot to do. A lot to do tonight and stuff. Oh, bombs. Bombs are great for this room, actually. Oh my god. Alright, one more time. That one didn't count. Oh, the cactus! Really great strategy here. Take the sword out. Oh no! Oh! Ruined! Ruined it. I ate the cactus in the wrong room. Put my sword away and all that. Every bit of health counts here. Wait, I haven't done it yet. Should be celebrating. Yeah, health. Give me some health. Jib's really busy on this level. Yeah! Yes, the 300 strategy. Let's go! The sweet pool of semen. Going monkeys forever. Yeah, it worked. Wow, I'm actually proud of the accomplishments in this level. Playthrough accomplishments. Yes. All right, you guys. So that's it for today. I gotta get some dinner and stuff and take a break here. So hope you all have a great evening, night, morning, whatever it is for you. And I'll probably be streaming tomorrow. I'm not exactly sure, but probably tomorrow. And the alpha update comes out this Wednesday, so you guys will be able to play this Wednesday. You got the alpha version. So cheers, everybody. See ya.